life in Christ. Sponsored by Brother Leo Cordes.
Romans chapter 8 from verse 24. Let's take a look at the Bible. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 24. For we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for? Are you following this reasoning? All right, next verse. But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. What is he telling you? The beauty of hope. But he tells you that hope is in the future. Hope is in the future. See that? We hope for that which we haven't seen. So we see it afar off, and so we wait patiently for it. That tells you why some people say, I know I'm going to be healed. I know that one day I'm going to walk. I know that one day my Redeemer will come. I know that one day everything is going to be all right. I just know it's in the future. I know. So I'm waiting patiently. The trouble is, in Christianity, understand, in Christianity, our only hope is about Jesus coming back. Are you hearing me? Hope has never created anything. Hope is always in the future. Hope has never created anything. And as long as you are hoping and hoping, hope is beautiful. Don't misunderstand me. Hope is a virtue. Hope has given a lot of people strength. Strength to continue their suffering. Yeah. Hope is beautiful. It's given many people the ability to struggle on. Say, we are on. We are still hoping. Say, how is everything? Say, we are hoping. They think it's lovely, and it's lovely. But the trouble is, that's not what they want in their lives. And they can't understand why the hope never comes. It's hope. As long as it is hope, it's not going to come. It's got to be in the future. So we patiently wait. God only knows when it will stop being hope. I'll show you something from the Bible in a second. I hope. I'm really hoping my business. I'm really hoping. Some Christians have twisted that to, or rather changed that to believing. I'm believing God. You are in the process of believing. God didn't say he that is believing. He said he that believes has. So you must transcend believing to having. If I am a believer, then I am a haver. So I stop making my I believe to what I have. Look at this. Let's remember the simple scripture that we all learned when we were kids. For God so loved the world, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have. He says, anybody who believes should not perish but have everlasting life. Great. So I ask people, do you believe in Jesus? Oh, yes. But Jesus said, anybody who believes should not perish. That's not a promise. That's a law. That's the sovereign declaration of Almighty God that separates you from perishing. Whosoever believes should not perish. It's God's decree. Do you get it? He has decreed that the believer should not perish. John chapter 6 verse 47 says, he that believeth hath. He has it. He's not going to have it. He's got it. So when I believed, I got something. Okay, look at it. You did an entrance examination. And then they gave you an admission letter. And they say, anybody who gets that admission letter should come to the registrar's office and get registered. So I got my admission letter, and I went to the registrar's office, and I got registered. Who am I? Now that I'm registered, who am I? An applicant?
No.
I was an applicant. And once I received the admission, I was admitted and I got registered. I am no longer an applicant. I am no longer registering, believing. I'm now a student. So they asked me, so what are you doing now? Oh, I'm a student of such and such a school. I don't say, well, I'm hoping to enter. I have entered. The other guy may be hoping to enter. Now, you got to apply the same understanding in spiritual knowledge. What God says belongs to you, belongs to you.
This teaching is now available to edify, enlighten, and give you a clear rendering on what many have grappled with for a long time. Number one, why do people sin?
Two reasons. For all sin, any sin, the two reasons. And you sin because of either one of them or both.
Number two, when does God forgive?
When does the Father forgive? And on what grounds can He forgive?
Number three, what is the basis for justification?
Justified? That means declared not guilty. How can a sinner be declared not guilty of the sin that he committed?
Sin, Forgiveness, and Righteousness is now available just for you. An understanding of this message will give you a clearer picture into God's ways of dealing with His children. Sin, Forgiveness, and Righteousness. It is now available on DVD and on the Pastor Chris Digital Library app for Android and iOS devices. Download and take it wherever you go. God bless you.
Pastor Chris, worth hearing. The Bible is replete with stories of men of faith, how they transcended from hoping in God to having faith in God. In this exhilarating teaching, learn how to transcend from confidence in God to real faith in God.
Hallelujah. You still there? So, what are you going to do with hope and faith? Hope is beautiful. Faith is beautiful, but they're not the same. They're not the same. As long as you are hoping, it will not work. It will not come. It's in the future. It's got to move from hope to faith. And I want to show you how. Now, the Bible tells us about a man that we are all connected to because of the blessing that God gave to him. His name is Abraham. He's called in the Bible the father of faith. Faith. Not because he was the first person to have faith in that sense, but something about his faith that moved from confidence in God to real faith. Because you see, faith sometimes is described as confidence in the unseen, but it's much more than that. But let's see about Abraham and what he did. You ready for this? Good. Romans chapter 4, and we start reading from verse number 17. As it is written, this is wonderful. Listen to the tenses. Okay, this is amazing. As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations. Now, what you got there in parentheses is quoting God in the Old Testament when God spoke to Abraham, book of Genesis, all right? He said to him, I have made you a father of many nations. Now, at the time that God said that to him, he had no child. God didn't say, I'm going to make you a father of many nations. He said, I have made you a father of many nations. The man had no child. And after God said it, children didn't pop out. If you had no child after God said that. So what's he going to do? Imagine this. God even changed his name. God even changed his name. He said, your name will no longer be Abram, but Abraham. Because I have made you a father of many nations. Imagine this. He had no child. Then he comes for, he gathers his friends. Remember, he had about 300 servants in his house. 300. That's what the Bible says. So he's got to do this publicly because he's changing his name. He can't do it secretly. They're going to have to call him by his new name. So he calls everybody and he says, hello, from this day, my name is no longer Abram, but Abraham. My name is father of many. So they wonder, because the understanding here is not, the first one was exalted father, which is stretched to assumed father, which means that people called him father, even though he was not their father. You understand that? But now he said, I am the father of many. I'm a real father. I have children by birth. So they're all looking at him. And my wife's name is Sarah. She is the mother of princes. And they're looking at him. She's 75 years old. And finally, they move on in their lives, and Abraham can't understand why it's not happening yet. It's not happening yet. So one day, God said to him, I want you to look at the stars if you can number them. He looks and God says, so shall your seed be. He's helping his faith. That's why, you see, when you hear the word of God, don't turn your mind to all the wrong things. Every day you're looking at, they said the Naira is shooting up. Say, it's shooting up. Hey, it's 300. Hey, it's 350. Hey, hey. Oh God, what am I going to do? You're looking at the wrong thing. Go look at the word. Then he got it. He got it. He got the understanding. He got it. Can I show it to you? All right. Back there, 17th verse. Good. As this written, I have made thee a father of many nations before him whom he believed. See, God, even God, look at what he says about God. God who quickeneth the dead. That means who makes alive the dead. He says, Abraham believed in God that raises the dead. That means Abraham understood the kind of God he was serving. My God can raise the dead, which means Abraham had come to the point in his life, he said, it's never too late, because he was now an old man.
Stay tuned.
Say, I'm a worker together with God. I'm a tree of righteousness. I bear fruits of righteousness. Because I'm a tree of righteousness. Three of us are going to become 30. And then 30 of us become 300. And 300 of us, 3,000. And we go for 30,000. This tree is becoming a forest. Shout amen, somebody.
This timely message, Every Tree a Forest, is now available on DVD. Also available for instant download at the Pastor Chris Digital Library app on Google Play and Apple App Store. Visit the Church Ministry Material Stand to get your copy. God bless you. Hebrews 11:1 says, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Be inspired in this episode as Pastor Chris continues to teach on how to transcend from confidence in God to real faith in God.
Oh, yeah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Can we finish this thing? All right, go back to that scripture about Abraham. Let's quickly finish it. Verse 17, we were. As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations before him whom he believed, even God who quickeneth the dead and calleth those things which be not as though they were. He calls things which be not as though they were. He calls things that don't exist in the senses as though they already existed. Did you get that? So, I'm a success. Glory to God. Yeah. And I'm walking the path of victory and prosperity. Is that right? And in my path, there is no death. And in my path, there is no failure. Are you following this? God calls things that be not as though they were. Can you see how that even though you're 15 years old, you don't have to wait until everything, maybe when I grow up, I will have a car. No, I have a car. I do have. In fact, I got cars. In fact, I got houses. In fact, I got a lot of money too. Hallelujah. Are you following this now? He calls things that be not as though they were. So now you can start planning, declaring your future. You're getting it now. Now let's see how he transited. Go back to that verse. Now he says, God who calls things that be not as though they were. Verse 18. Who against hope? Abraham, who against hope? It was a hopeless situation already. You remember? About 100 years old. Against hope. He believed in hope. What? Against hope. He believed in hope that he might become the father of many nations. According to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. He believed in hope. Against hope. Did you ever hear some people say, well, just hoping against hope? No, you've got to move like Abraham. Look at it. He was hoping against hope, but he had to change. Watch. Next verse. And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body now dead. That means now as good as dead. He considered not the circumstances. I will not consider the circumstances. They said, they've written your name among those that are going to fire. He said, that doesn't make a difference. I'm a child of God. It doesn't make a difference. I'm a success. Glory to God. Doesn't make a difference. I have no worries. Be anxious for nothing. And be not weak in faith. He considered not the circumstances. He considered not. Don't consider the situation. You say, look, consider how things are going. In fact, if you consider the situation, say, I refuse to consider the situation. He considered not his own body. He considered not his own body. Oh, they said, the doctor said, I'll never have a child. He considered not his own body when he was about 100 years old. Neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He refused also to consider the deadness of Sarah's womb. But he was strong in faith. No. Oh, look at it. He staggered at, like the first part. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief. Watch this. He staggered not. You know what it is to stagger, to waver, to go this way and that way. He staggered not at the promise of God. See, I don't understand. I know what the Lord said to me, but I don't know why things are not just going in the right direction. You are staggering. You're staggering. He staggered not at the promise of God, but he was strong in faith. He was strong in faith, giving glory. That means he was testifying, giving glory. He was testifying, giving glory to God. Let me show you something about God. Give me again from the ASV. Give me Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12 from the ASV. You like this. Then said Jehovah unto me, thou hast well seen. Read the rest. 1, 2, go. Hallelujah. Jehovah says, I watch over my word to perform it. In other words, when God has spoken, he keeps a watch over it to make sure it comes to pass. So if you will proclaim it, he will bring it to pass. That's why Jesus is called the high priest of our confession. He's the one that brings it to pass. If you will say it, if you will say it, if you will say it and refuse to stagger, he will watch over his word to perform it. Can you shout amen, somebody? Amen.